she laid him in a manger. He was still her little child in a city filled with strangers. He was still her little child. Though the inn was full and the night was cold, she held him close and smiled. And when she laid him in a manger, he was still her little child. When the angels called him Savior, he was still her little child. When the wise men gave him treasures, he was still her little child. When the shepherds bowed before him, a star shone all the while. When the angels called him Savior, he was still her little child. And when he grew in strength and wisdom, he was still her little child. When he spoke, the people listened. He was still her little child. And when he healed the lame,
Carlotta Brett Pierce is charged in connection with the death of her 4-year-old daughter Marchella, assault, reckless endangerment, endangering the welfare of a child, along with low-level drug charges including unlawful possession of marijuana. That after police say they found a small amount in the house. Police also say there's a possibility Marchella was tied down to her bed. While there was bruising on her ankles and wrists, the medical examiner's report on how she died is inconclusive.
I don't believe it because I have a niece to say.
Tyrone Pierce says his daughter Marchella was a sickly child, born weighing slightly over a pound, and with underdeveloped lungs, she spent most of her life in the hospital.
Though she still had trouble breathing, Marchella was finally sent home to live with her family back in February. And as a shrine of candles and stuffed animals sits in her memory, some neighbors here insist her mother was a good one.
She never was a physical mother. Like, she'd scream at them, she'd be like, don't do it. She'll warn them, but she won't, like, reenact with them, like, oh, I'm about to hit you. She a nice mother.
When Marchella came home from the hospital, the Administration for Children's Services hired an outside company to help the family. But now ACS is investigating if that agency actually did its job. And in the wake of the death of Nixzmary Brown, Marchella's death is yet another wake-up call.
We know we're going to have a tough city budget this next year and the year after that. And I hope this is a wake-up call to say we can't lose children, you know, who could have saved.
And while Marchella may be gone, her memory is still alive on Madison Avenue. In Bedford-Stuyvesant, I'm Tatiana Anderson, New York One.
Through the shake of it.